Good morning, students. And we are going to discuss the rest of the part of this chapter. In my earlier class, I have discussed up to the motor, and after motor, the rest of the part we will discuss. I will discuss now. This is chapter 13, magnetic effects of electric current, of class 10, general science. Now, however, I have discussed up to that much, we have seen that current carrying conductor behaves like a magnet. That means due to the current, magnetic properties are, magnets are forming, magnetic properties are attaining. That means when current is flowing through a conductor, magnetic properties are attained by that conductor. Now, due to current, we have learned up to this much, we have discussed up to this much, that due to current, magnetic field is created. Now, I will discuss that, is it possible to, that due to magnetic field, current, electric field is created. Due to magnetic field, electric field is created. Earlier, I have discussed due to electric field, magnetic field is created up to that much. But now, we will discuss that due to magnetic field, electric field is created. That is the opposite one. And that is electromagnetic induction. And this is first in 1831, studied by English physicist Michael Faraday. Faraday made an important breakthrough by discovering how a moving magnet can be used to generate electric currents. How a moving magnet can be used to generate electric currents. That is first discovered by English physicist Michael Faraday in the year 1831, and that is electromagnetic induction. There he did the experiment. He has taken huge strands of wire, and the two ends of the wire there. These two ends are connected with the galvanometer. Now, galvanometer means what? Galvanometer is the device which can measure a induced potential difference. That means galvanometer is a device which can measure a very, 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 very small amount of potential difference is also created. That also can be measured, as well as electric current also. A very small amount of electric current is established, that also can be measured by that galvanometer. This is the device known as galvanometer. Now, he has taken huge amount of tons of wires, and the two ends of the wires are connected with the galvanometer. And he has kept the wire like that. They are the tons, huge turns are there, and he has taken one bar magnet. This is the north pole of the bar magnet, this is the south pole, bar, north pole, south pole, this and north pole, this and south pole. Now, keep casing the wire, these two ends are connected with the galvanometer, and here the huge numbers of turns are there. Casing the wire here, he is bringing this bar magnet near the magnet and taking it away from the magnet like this. Casing the wire like this, here the huge turns. Through the turns, is inside the turns, is bringing this magnet, again taking it outside the turn, again inside the turn, again outside the turn, like this continuously, moving the magnet like this continuously. After a huge number of movement, it was observed that in galvanometer, the needle of the galvanometer shows a certain types of deflection. The needle of the galvanometer shows a certain types of deflection after the continuous movement of this bar magnet through the turns of the wire. So this means what? That why this needle of the galvanometer showing the deflection? This is because galvanometer, needle of the galvanometer shows deflection only when there is a small amount of also potential difference is created. That means here certain amount of potential difference is created. That means certain amount of potential difference is induced, and because of which there is induced current. Since we know that in the last chapter we have discussed that in the electric chapter we have discussed where is the potential difference, there is a current. So since the potential difference is induced, so there is potential difference is induced, so there is induced current. So this is electromagnetic induction. That means due to the movement of magnet, electric field is created, and for which we are getting the induced voltage and induced current. So by this law, this has been established, that is, by moving the magnet we can generate electricity. By the movement of magnet we can generate electricity. Now there is interesting another thing is there. Suppose here some iron nails. Here some iron nails, and they are this one is connected with the battery. Here one key. This one is connected with the galvanometer. Now with the iron nail, two loops of wires are connected, wires are attached with these iron nails, bundle of iron nails, and in one end, in one wire battery is connected, and in another wire galvanometer is connected. There is no connection between these two wires. There is no connection between these two wires. These are insulated wires, and one is with, in one battery is connected, and in another galvanometer is connected. Now when key is on, current is moving this direction. When key is on, galvanometer is showing the deflection. When key is off also, then also galvanometer showing the deflection, whereas there is no connection between these two wires. So how this is possible is the question arises. When key is on, we will try to understand now. When key is on, this current is moving in this wire. When current is moving in this wire, definitely that conducting wire becomes magnet. As our Oster told, that every current can be conducted behaves like a magnet. So definitely this wire behaves like a magnet. And since these wires are behaving like a magnet, when current is passing through it, then surrounding this wire, a magnetic field is created. Surrounding this wire and a magnetic field is created, and since these are the bundles of iron nails, so these are the conductor of this magnetic field. So definitely the huge magnetic field is created surrounding the this bundle of iron nails, and because of this magnetic field, here also magnetic field is created. This wire is also came inside the magnetic field. Now when the key is on, current is passing, then magnetic field is created. That means slowly magnetic field is created. Earlier first magnetic field 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. So magnetic field rising continuously, rising and reached up to a maximum level. So here when switch is off, then current is off. When switch off, current is off, current is not flowing, but magnetic field then and there does not become zero. At the same moment, magnetic field also does not become zero. Magnetic field slowly coming to zero. Earlier it raised from 0 to 5, now 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. So there is a change of magnetic field. In earlier case, when this experiment is done, when magnet is coming near the coil, when magnet is coming near the rounded coil, then when coming near the coil, much more magnetic lines of force going inside the coil. When going away, then less. When coming again near, then more. When going away, then less. So there is a difference in magnetic field created. Because of that difference, this potential difference is created, and because of that potential difference, momentary current is created, and because of this, galvanometer shows the deflection in earlier experiment. When this one coming near the coil, then maximum amount of magnetic fields induced in the coil. When getting away, then less. When coming, then maximum induced. So there is a difference created. Here also same way, when current is off, switch off, then magnetic field decreases from 5 to 0. When switch on, magnetic field rises from 0 to 5. So there is a difference is created. Because of that difference in magnetic field is created. Because of that difference in magnetic field, a potential difference is created, and because of which this the momentary current is created, and for that reason galvanometer needle shows the deflection. So we can say that current is moving through a conductor and galvanometer shows the deflection in nearby conductor. So because of this change in magnetic field, a potential difference is induced and momentary current is produced, and because of this galvanometer shows the deflection. Now we understood that due to the movement of magnetic field, current can be generated. Now based on this, Fleming again came, and Fleming again given the rule. And now earlier given the Fleming left hand rule, and now Fleming given the Fleming right hand rule. According to right hand rule, same way like earlier, if we stretch the finger, if we stretch our finger, then this one is the movement, then this is magnetic field, this is current. This one is the movement, magnetic field, current. Now when movement or force, you can say force. In earlier case, when magnetic field and current was perpendicular to each other, then force is created. Now force is applied when this magnetic field is rotated perpendicularly. Both force and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other, and this force is applied to the magnet and it is rotating perpendicularly, then a momentary current or the current is generated, which is also perpendicular to both of them. So he explained this law by this right hand thumb rule. This is Fleming's right hand rule. Sorry, Fleming's not thumb rule. Fleming's right hand rule. In Fleming's right hand rule, he explained that this is the force. This our thumb is indicating the force, and which is perpendicular to the magnetic field. Our pointing finger. Then there is a current will be generated, which is also perpendicular to both of them, and there will be current is generated due to the movement of this magnetic field perpendicularly. Now both magnetic field and current also perpendicular to each other, and this current and force is also perpendicular to each other. So that means he explained this rule by using this right hand. So this is given by Fleming's right hand rule. That means we can say that if we rotate magnet perpendicularly by applying the force perpendicularly, then a current is generated which is also perpendicular to both of them. So rotating the magnet, current can be generated. Earlier, flowing current, magnetic field can be generated. Now it is established that moving magnet, electric field can be generated. Based on this idea, electric generator is discovered. Electric generator. A schematic diagram of electric generator I am doing. It's like motor. Just like motor, these are earlier in motor splitting was used. This is not splitting, this is commutator. This one also, this one is C1, this one is C2, this one is brush B2, this one is B1. So function is same, like slip ring and brush, like earlier function same. Here we are rotating this armature ABCD. We are rotating this armature continuously, and due to that rotation, electric current is generated, which can be shown or measured by this galvanometer. Now magnetic field is there. Magnetic field there from north to south. Now, using the Fleming's right hand rule, we can try to understand. This is the force upward, magnetic field north to south, magnetic field north to south. Force upward, magnetic field north to south, then current will be from A to B. Current will be from A to B. So force upward, magnetic field from north to south. This is magnetic field, this is force. Then current will be from A to B. Now force downward. That means this way. Magnetic field from north pole to south pole, N to S. Current from C to D. So first force, half rotation, force upward, then this way moving, then current is from A to B, and when force downward, then current is moving from C to D. So this is the diagram of AC generator. This two direction of current is maintained by these two commutators. You see, two commutators are connected. This commutator A to B direction is maintained, and this commutator C to D direction is maintained. So both the directions we are getting here, So A to B also, C to D also, this way also, this way also. So both are maintained by this commutator and brush. So brush is helping. So here A to B direction is maintained by this commutator. You see, this C1 is not connected with this wire, and this C2 is not connected with this wire. This both are separate. So that's why both the directions are maintained, and that's why it is called AC, because both directions we are getting, this way. So that's why this is the diagram of AC generator. So here, when rotating from the Fleming's right hand rule, we can understand easily that when coming upward, then current is from A to B. When going downward, then current is from C to D. So this is maintained by this commutator C1 and C2. That's why two commutators are used, C1 and C2, and the two brushes are there, B1 and B2. So this is AC generator. We can make it DC generator also. DC, just instead of using two commutator, if we use only single commutator, then A to B, C to D, this one direction will be maintained. only one direction. Here two directions are maintained, that's why you see, and single directions can be maintained by, instead of using the two commutator, by using one commutator. Here nowadays in all the generators are AC generator, so that's why two commutators are used in every year. And by joining this C1 and C2 and making them one only, we can make it, we can convert AC to DC also. So this is the difference between the AC generator and DC generator. Here since two directions are maintained, so this is AC generator. Single direction, then DC generator will be. So this is the working principle of generator. Using this Fleming's right hand rule, we can try to understand, we can easily understand that the direction of current, how it is produced and how current is produced. Now in our area, in our country, in India, since AC generator, the frequency is 50 hertz. Frequency of AC current is 50 hertz. Frequency of AC current, 50 hertz. Now frequency 50 hertz, then 50 hertz means number of 50 oscillations are completed in 1 second. Every charged particles, every electrons changing their direction, completing the oscillation in 1 second 50 times. Then changing the direction, if oscillation, one oscillation completed from there, from here started, here came, again going there, then one oscillation completed. This is 2, 3, 4. Then in one oscillation, direction how many times completing? Direction how many times changing? From there started, here came, then there gone. This is one direction, this is another direction. This is one oscillation completed. That means in one oscillation, direction changing 2 times. Then in 50 oscillation, direction changing 100 times. That means our charged particle in our India, in our country, 100 times these charged particles are changing their directions in AC current. In America, 60 hertz. So 120 times changing their directions. Now we will discuss about the domestic electric circuit. In domestic electric circuit, we have seen that 3 wires are there: green color wire, red color wire, and black color wire. 3 wires you have seen that green color wire. First, in electric from our main line, this when current is wire is coming and joining to the electric board or fuse. This main switch, we are telling main switch, this is electric board or fuse. From meter, first meter, then meter to electric board or switch, and first to electric board or main switch, then main switch to electric meter, then electric meter to distributing box or MCB, and then MCB to different parts of the house. Now green color wire, that is called earth wire. Red color wire is the live wire, and black color wire is the neutral wire. So we have seen that plug point is there, three plug point, three pin plug also there, two pin plug also there. In three pin plug, one is in the top and two are at the bottom. So top one is the earth wire for earthing, and at the bottom two are there. Among them, one is live and another is neutral. So live one is called phase, and another is neutral. Now in major equipments, whatever used in our household, for example fridge, for example like fridge motor, so here we must use a 3-pin plug instead of the 2-pin plug. And in fridge, 3-pin plug is there, 2-pin plug is not there. You have seen also, you may see also. So we have to be conscious sometimes at the time of using the electric current. Whenever motor is running in our house, that time we should not run any other equipments like pressing iron, like any other motor, like microwave, like grinder machine. So when one motor is running, so if motor is running also, grinder machine also is running also, microwave is also running, So then huge load will be there in that house. So that can create the short circuit, and that can cause the fire, and that can cause the accident. So we have to be conscious regarding this. And also sometimes we have seen that we are using in one plug point, many plugs we are using. Then one plug point in our area, generally the plug point which one in our household we are using normally, these are 5 ampere plug point. Now this 5 ampere plug point can supply 5 ampere current only, 5 ampere current. Now if we use the motor plug in that 5 ampere, one motor plug require at least 15 ampere plug point. So that cannot, this 5 ampere one cannot supply that much to motor plug to run the motor. And that if we are forcing to run the motor, and that creates the short circuit. That will damage the devices, that will damage the equipment, that can create the fire also in our house. That can causes the damage of building also, and our life also are in threat. So we have to conscious about this. And on that we have seen that we are using in one 5 ampere plug point, we are using multi plug, and in that multi plug we are using pressing iron, we are using mobile charger, we are using any other lamp, we are using any other thing. So huge load in that 5 ampere plug point. So due to that huge load, it can also create the short circuit, and it can cause also fire. So for these reasons, we must have to use MCB at our house. MCB means miniature circuit breaker. So when there will be a huge load or any shortfall in the circuit or short circuit, that MCB will fall down, and it will save the room, it will save the house, it will save the circuit also. So that MCB must be used in our household, and for every room, for every corner, this one MCB must be there. And for in general, for whole house, one MCB, big MCB must be there. That can save us, that can save the household. So we must not use the multi plug, and we must be conscious about these things. And our earthing must be active and must be in a good condition. Our house earthing must be, because earthing wire, earth wire, that is the green wire, why it is used, because sometimes a huge voltage or huge current is flowing through the circuit of the house, then that overflow or the excess one can go through this earth wire and can go under the earth. Or suppose the thunder, due to the thunderstorm or the sparking, this suddenly the huge voltage and coming, and that can flow through this earth wire and can save the house building. So these things we must have to be keep in our mind. I wish you understand the chapter. This is the end of the whole chapter, and I wish that you don't have any doubt. If you have any doubt, then at night you can call me from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. Within 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. you can call me, and you can ask, you can clarify your doubts, you can ask me the question, whatever and wherever you have doubt, and relate my discussion with the topic. There is the textbook, whatever written, and go through the textbook and try to understand and try to relate the discussion. Then I wish that all the topic, whatever I have discussed, you can understand easily. And whatever the questions and in exercise given, that are given to you to learn and answer, and go through my discussion and try to answer all the questions whatever given in your exercise. Thank you very much. Thank you.